So now we are going to talk about the differences between the term and the preterm baby. Okay. So the first, the thing that we are going to talk about is the posture of the baby when the child is born. A normal child when he is born, he is in a flexion position. That is flexed inside. Okay. That is a flexion position. And the preterm baby will not be in the flexion position. That is a decreased tone. The tone of the baby will be decreased. So the position is the extension position. Means the hand of the baby will not be flexed, but will be relaxed. That is the extension position. Okay. So the second sign that we can see on difference, that is the scarf sign. That is the elbow does not cross the midline. Means in a baby, that is on the term baby, the flexion is more. The hand will not cross the midline of the chest. Okay. So that is that elbow does not cross the midline. Okay. But the child, that is a preterm baby, the position of the hand is decreased, the tone of the hand is decreased, so the hand will easily cross the midline. Okay, so that is the elbow crosses the midline. Third, here we talk about the breast bud. The breast bud is the nipple that we are talking about of the newborn. Okay, if the size of the breast bud is more than the 5 mm, that is the child is a term baby. If the breast bud size is less than the 5 mm, then the child is a preterm child. Okay. So now we are seeing the genitalia of the baby. If the child born is a male child, we see that the rugae present in the testes are much more. They are present in a very normal condition. Their rugae are present in a very sufficient amount. And the testes, if we palpable the testes, they are palpable. The testes are present inside the scrotum. Okay. But if a child is a preterm male child, if a male child is preterm, there are absent rugae or reduced rugae. Okay. The second, if the testes usually are not palpable, means the testes are not descended in the scrotum, the testes remain in the abdominal area. So there may be requirement for the operation for that, or maybe if we wait for some time, the testes descend automatically in the scrotum. So now if a female child is born at term, the labia majora covers the labia minora. You know the anatomy of labia, so you can understand that the labia majora covers the labia minora. But if a female child who is born at preterm, she is born, then the labia majora and labia minora are equally visible. Means the labia majora does not cover the labia minora. Means that they are not developed properly. Okay. So the fifth part that we are talking about here is the ear recoil. That is fast in the term babies and slow in the preterm baby. Means if we just recoil the hair of the child, it moves back to their position in a very fast rate. But if a child is a preterm baby, if we recoil the ear of the child, it will go back very slowly. Also, the preterm child, that is lanugo hair, that is the hairs on the body of the baby, will be in a very high amount in a preterm baby. But whereas in a term baby, the lanugo hair are very less amount or absent. So there is no need to write, but you can understand what are the differences between the term and the preterm baby. The first is that are the posture, scarf sign, breast bud and genitalia, that is the male and the female, and the ear recoil.